So now let's go back to our split example. Let me rearrange things a little bit to make more room. So now I'm going to put the domains for size and for string one next to the other. So let's look at what some possible inputs will be for the subdomains that we identified when we use the idea of selecting inputs at the boundary. If we look at the first subdomain, size less than 0, one reasonable input is size equals to minus 1, because minus 1 is the boundary value for the domain of the integers less than 0. If we look at the third subdomain, a possibly interesting case is the one of size equal to 1, for the same reasoning that we used for the previous subdomain, for size less than 0. And let's try to select another one for this subdomain, for the integers greater than 0, if there is a concept of maximum integer, we can select that one as our boundary value. And of course, we could select much more, but this is just to give you an idea. Other possible inputs, one interesting example for the first one, string with length less than size, will be a string with length size minus 1. Again, this is the boundary value for this domain. And we could continue in this way, like for example, selecting a string whose length is exactly size as a boundary value for this other domain, and so on. And we will get back actually to this example and look at it in a more extensive way when we talk about the specific method for doing this kind of process.